I know that, sir. But think of the disastrous effect this might have on the morale of the American teenager. No, I am not suggesting that the boy does not want to go into the army. 2 weeks from today, he'll be there. Rosie, thank goodness you've come. This is the end of the Almanzi Music Corporation. Comrade Birdie's going into the army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert.
Rosie, you can't, not today of all days. My pills, where are my pills? The little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much, break it in half.
You're 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin. My mind is made up. I've been with Aume Lu 8 years now, and for what? A $5 raise in 1954? I want something more than that.
Rosie, if you're referring to anything of more permanent nature between you and me, I'm not ready for it. And as part of the company you're after, the answer is no to that too. Aume Lu is me, Mama, and Lu. And any change in that would kill that wonderful woman.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert, except maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop poor Lu either. He loved you, Rose.
I love Lu too, but he died 6 years ago. And besides, he was a wire-haired terrier. Anyhow, I don't want part of the company. This is something much more important.
Rosie, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss. Conrad Birdie's going into the army. I've quit. There's nothing you can do except to give up the business and go back to college and get your...
Rosie, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Will you listen to me, Albert? I'm serious. He's going in the army is the best thing he could do. Now you're free to start to do what he wanted to. Albert, I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be for a year. But it's 8 years, Albert. 8 long years, Albert.
Rosie, it takes time to build a business.
It was only a sideline, that's what you said. Just needed some money, that's what you said. Going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, you were going to NYU and become...
Don't say it, Rosie.
An English teacher.
Rosie.
And furthermore, he wrote poetry.
Rose, please.
An English teacher, an English teacher. If only you've been an English teacher. We have a little apartment in Queens. You get a summer vacation, and we would know what life means. A man who's
Conrad Birdie Fan Club, number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Mary, could you get me Sweet Apple, Ohio? The number's 77-8820, and call me right back.
Now, wait a minute. Who's Kim whatever her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit song this business has ever seen. And it's called One Last Kiss.
I never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie on his way into the big, cold army for 2 long years, and when he gives that kiss to one of his fans chosen at random, it'll make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
We cut the record here in New York.
Take Conrad to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college the rest of your life.
And I promise you, as soon as this thing is settled, it'll be just the two of us, Rose, in perfect bliss. Bliss. Kiss. That rhymes. I wonder if anyone used it before. Oh, what difference does it make? It'll be great for the song.
Yes? Well, every phone in Sweet Apple can't be busy. What's going on over there? Kim McAfee just got pinned to who? Oh, never mind, Mary. Keep trying and call me right back.
Daddy! anybody gave you this pin doesn't mean you have to retire from all social life.
I'm sorry, Ursula, but my mind's made up. Of course I'll still play his records, but things like the pledge and the Conrad Birdie scream are past me now.
You're giving up the scream?
You mean when Conrad Birdie sings, you're not gonna go, ah! Oh, Kim.
Please get off the phone. I've got some calls to make.
All right, Mother. Sorry, Ursula. I've got to hang up. I mean, really, Kim, are you absolutely sure?
Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old, and it's time I settled down.
When your skinny child of 14 wired with braces from ear to ear, you doubt that you could ever be appealing. Then hallelujah, you are 15 and the braces disappear and your skin is smooth and clear and you have
gray skies are gonna clear up, put on a hat.
Chocolate Cloud and cheer up. Put on a happy face. Take off the gloomy mask of tragedy. It's not your style. You'll look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook. Stick up that noble chin. Wipe off that full of doubt look. Slap on a happy grin. Ha! And spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. And if you're feeling cross and bitterish, don't sit and whine. Take out banana splits and licorice and you'll feel fine. So gloomy, she never laughed or sing. She wouldn't listen to me. Now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Conrad before he goes. Would you get that stuff down to track 12 on the double? Oh, Rosie, what are you doing?
Getting our things to the station, Albert, without any help from you.
I'm sorry, Rose. I don't suppose a generous tip would make things up.
Just get down to the train before any of those reporters talk to Conrad alone.
I've got to wait here for Mama.
Have you told her about dissolving Aunt May Lou yet?
I couldn't, Rosie. Yesterday was the anniversary of Lou being hit by a milk truck on 181st Street in Broadway.
Yoo-hoo! Sonny!
Mama, what's the matter?
Don't worry about me, Sonny. I'm just a little faint from the subway.
Mama, I told you to take a taxi.
Taxi? What do I need with taxis? I'll save the taxis for my successful son. A mother could ride crowded in a dirty subway full of people who wouldn't give you a seat if your life depended on it. But what's the difference? Nowadays, a mother's lower than dirt anyway. Who's she?
Mama, you know Rose Alvarez from The Office?
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez. I can't believe it. Rose, what happened? You had a sudden shock or something?
Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll go see if Conrad is here.
Look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older man doesn't snatch her up. A personable matron like that, with brains and a few dollars. Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Mama, what I sort of wanted to discuss with you was about Rose. Maybe you'd better sit down.
Why? I know my Sonny. He loves his mama. He isn't going to say anything that would break her heart. Go ahead, dear. What about Rose?
Well, it's about Lou, too.
Lou? Where are you, Lou? What about Lou?
Well, Mama, Rose thinks, and I agree, that I should give up on my Lou.
Oh!
Mama, what's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. You've killed me, that's all. Lou, I'm coming. I'm on my way up.
Mama, here's some money. Take a cab home. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing is too crowded for a mother. Wait a minute. How many blocks is it after all? Only 107. I'll walk. Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Wear a heavy coat. And eat a hot lunch.
gently.
Well, as a matter of fact, Rosie, I didn't tell her at all. I mean, she was so upset.
You mean you didn't?
He's coming! Conrad Birdie's coming!
Later, Rosie. Conrad's coming, and we can't let him talk to those reporters alone. How does he feel? You ask how he feels? He's much too shy to tell you, so I'll tell you how he feels. He feels brave and eager, strangely humble, proud to be a plain GI.
He will gladly face those bullets, for he's not afraid to die.
For he's a fine-standing, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.
And that's why he volunteered for...
Engaged.
She's a real pal, like a sister, but it doesn't mean a thing. At the 80 carat diamond, it was just a friendship ring.
For he's a fine-standing, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.
Chosen to bestow your final kiss upon, and who will now lead us in reciting the Conrad Birdie Pledge. Kim McAbee.
Upset about this, and I've had several headaches and a nosebleed.
Why, Hugo, I believe you're actually jealous.
jealous of Conrad Birdie.
Me jealous? I'm the total opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous, and I have every right to be. Kim's my steady.
That's just it, Hugo. I'm your steady. Oh, I may admire Conrad Birdie as one admires a far, distant, and unattainable ideal. But I'm pinned to you, Hugo, and I don't care how common and ordinary you are. And that's how I'm going to stay.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better.
Does that. Why, even when I say his name, I don't feel a thing. Listen.